one of the world's highest lakes and the epicenter of the world's biggest military standoff. It is here in Ladakh in May 2020 that China triggered a historic military mobilization on both sides, a deployment that continues to this day with the two Asian giants massed against each other across the line of actual control. And now, nearly a year after the two sides disengaged from this tense friction point on the Pangong Lake's shores, forced by India's aggressive preemptive push into areas south of the lake, something has emerged. Take a close look at these images. What you're seeing is a 315-meter military bridge built by the Chinese across the narrowest point of the gigantic Himalayan lake. Maxar satellite images accessed by India Today show this under-construction bridge. Heavy construction equipment, including cranes, deployed in the area by Chinese engineers. Work on this bridge began in September last year. Built aggressively during the winter, the Chinese bridge is nearly complete. And once it is, it could be a game changer. Before the bridge was built, Chinese forces had to move nearly 300 kilometers or 10 hours around the lake to remobilize on the southern shores where the Indian Army had taken surprise aggressive postures in 2020. Now with this bridge, the Chinese Army can pour its forces into the Kailash Ranges area within just a couple of hours. In other words, the advantage India had in this area is being aggressively undermined by the Chinese. Taken aback by what the Indian Army had done in 2020 by occupying heights on the southern banks of the lake, the bridge represents China's attempt to make sure it can never happen again. India has strongly objected to the construction of the bridge in area held by the Chinese for over six decades.
A government has been monitoring this activity closely. This bridge is being constructed in areas that have been under the illegal occupation by China for around 60 years now. As you're well aware, India has never accepted such illegal occupation.
China has been rapidly building infrastructure, including roads and bridges in the region, including in the Galwan Valley, since the India-China standoff. India too has speeded up construction of roads and bridges for quick movement of men and material to match the Chinese deployments. But the Chinese bridge is by far the most aggressive move with iron and bricks in the ongoing Ladakh standoff.
This is going to change the entire dynamics of LAC because this infrastructure is not linked to the infrastructure development in Western Tibet, but with the aim of changing the status quo on the LAC now as well as in future.
It makes them logistically better and tactically better, gives them better battlefield mobility also. So I think China should be a little sensitive to the Indian concerns, and if they can do that, we also have certain options which are open to us.
While the under-construction bridge at Pangong So is only a fraction of the gigantic infrastructure overall deployed by China, it is also a prime reminder of China's true intentions and priorities with respect to India. In New Delhi, this is Ankit Kumar for India Today.